We have borrowed some objects from the world-famous British Optical Association Museum. And you each have, and I'm going to start with Phil, you have an optical object, and I'd like you to tell me what you think it might be.
Oh, right. Well, it's got a lovely leather surround.
Yes.
Right, so why would you want to see things this red?
Yeah.
Was it for a nascent superhero communist man?
Is that literally rose-tinted glasses? Are you feeling...
Ah, oh, the 80s! The Star Council! The Guardian with a decent header font. Oracoria! His crosswords were easy then!
As you can see, they look like flying goggles.
Yeah, yeah,
they do. That's what they are, but they're not for flying.
Then they're not flying goggles.
Don't
be picky, he doesn't like that.
They are for pilots. They're for night pilots. Ah, it's so they can acclimatise their eyes for darkness.
I would say that rather they make everyone you bump into look like a Dutch prostitute.
There is an element
to
that.
Dance for me, Stephen. Dance for me.
You are a unique individual, if you don't understand.
Why can't I dance without people laughing? I don't
know. You bring joy.
That lesson that everybody else went to at school where they were taught how to dance at a discotheque. Anyway, Alan, what have you got that's optical?
It looks like an ordinary pair of glasses.
It is.
Three...
Put them on and describe what you see.
I'm surprised to hear that my vision is somewhat obscure.
Yes. Look at the audience.
They make.
And what do I? What can you see?
They're like, see? Kind can of you... like binoculars where you can really see.
Can you see me doing anything?
No.
You're not working, Alan. Dance.
And they're meant to be for peripheral vision, then.
They were designed for drivers who had... who had bad eyesight, and it was to improve their peripheral vision. But it clearly doesn't work.
I mean, no chance of driving in these.
You feel like that all the time.
Well, that's unfortunate. Well... But thank you for trying them, and next up is Josh. What have you got?
They're very fashionable, aren't they?
If I were to tell you that these are, despite their modern look, they're actually way over 100 years old. They're mid-19th century. From the open carriage days of railways onwards, because of steam, smuts, so on, people got really stung in the eyes.
I'm sorry, who's speaking now?
Railway spectacles. Makes no sense. And yet it's funny.